Subtitles are wonderful for making TV content accessible for people or if a film's in another language.
But international research shows an increasing number of young people are watching everything with subtitles.
Subtitles, first invented not for film, but for theatre. In the form of cards when Italian opera was shown to German audiences. Many moons on, and the use of them seems to be soaring with the young'uns.
People were trolling me for watching TV with the subtitles on.
80% of British and American Gen Zs use them for everything. But why? And is it a thing here too?
But it's 2023 and I don't need a man to save me, thank you.
And for more on this, we're joined by trend spotter Jess Maloney. Lovely to see you again, Jess. Now tell us, why young people watching TV with subtitles?
Well, look, subtitles are just another way to get attention and to tell a story. What we know about online video is that if you've got subtitles on it, you're more likely to continue watching the video. So I think this is just an online trend that's now spilling over into the world where we watch videos on TV as well.
So, Jess, is the use of subtitles something to do with people doing lots of things at once?
Oh, look, it absolutely is. You just need to look at your own behaviour when you're sitting there watching TV. You know, you're quite often multitasking, your phone's probably at arm's reach. We're doing a lot more, and this behaviour of what is called second screening is very prevalent in young people, but also across, you know, everyone that uses a smartphone now. And so because we're more distracted, subtitles are just, well, I know I can speak for on my behalf, just another way that we kind of keep up to what's happening on that big screen.
Is it a good thing that we're using subtitles more?
Oh, look, I'm a huge fan of subtitles. I could be a little bit biased because I watch almost everything with subtitles on.
Really?
But look, at the end of the day, it is a really... Yeah, I do, but at the end of the day, it's a really good thing. You know, I don't just live with people that have English as a first language, so it's just another way of us being able to share stories where maybe English isn't their first language. There's also kind of a little bit more description that happens in those subtitles. It opens up the world for us to, you know, watch foreign language films and TV series, and I think subtitles are really excellent and here to stay.
Thank you so much, Jess. Lovely to talk to you.
Thank you.
And I think the other thing about subtitles is that sometimes they're quite useful. The modern television is a lot harder to hear. And I know people at home will be saying that because the speaker is on the back of the TV and that's stuck against the TV. There's no speaker on modern televisions. It's on the back. So you've got to crank it right up. I mean, my parents have got their TV on 79. Only goes up to 100.
As we speak, probably.
Absolutely, they're probably watching. And they still can't hear. Whereas the old-style TVs, the Philips K9 television, I mean, that had the big speaker at the front, and you could hear absolutely everything.
What a glorious television that was.
Pricey, though. $1,200 in 1973. That is very, very expensive.
So what would that be in modern money?
Around about $17,000 in modern money. Very expensive.